This is Mr. K. Raju. I am the assistant professor in CSE department. Today I am discussing about definition of operating system. So before going to operating system definition, we are discussing what is a software. Okay? So first of all, what is a software? Software is a collection of programs. Okay? Again, softwares are two types. One is application software. Second one is system software. Okay? So again, system software is divided into two types. One is operating system. Second one is utility software. Okay, so first of all, what is an application software? Application software is used for to performing one specific task for the user. Okay, so examples of MS Office. Next one, Gmail. Next one, web browser. Okay, these all comes under into the application softwares. Okay, next, utility softwares. What is utility softwares? These utility softwares are only used for to providing or improving the system performance. Okay, so example, antivirus. Next one, data cleaning. Next one, disk defragmentation, etc. So this type of software comes under into the utility softwares. Okay, so this type of softwares are used to improving the system performance. Okay, now coming to the operating system. Operating system is a one type of system software. Okay, so this is used to providing the interface between the computer user and computer hardware. Okay, so computer hardware nothing but, so operating system definition is providing interface between computer user and computer hardware. Okay, so computer hardware nothing but CPU. Next one, memory. Next one, input output device. Okay, so hardware nothing but CPU nothing but your processor. Next one, memory is nothing but RAM or ROM. Next one, input output device, nothing but keyboard, monitor and so on. Okay, this OS is providing interface between the computer user and computer hardware. Okay, next, what operating system will do? Okay, so operating system is providing some operations. First one is process management. Second one is memory management. And third one is storage management. And last one is protection and security. Okay, first one, process management, memory management, storage management, and last one, protection and security. Okay, so these are the operating system functionalities. Okay, first one, process, second one, memory, next one, storage, and last one, protection and security. Okay, so what is the structure of operating system? Okay, basically, your computer system structure is consists of four components. First one is hardware, Second one, application software. Next one, operating system. And last one, users. Okay, so diagram is system hardware. Next one is operating system. Next one is operating system. Next one is system and application software. System and application softwares. And last one, users. User 1, next one, user 2, next one, user 3, and so on, user N. User N. Okay? Example, application software examples, compilers, next one, text editor, next one, web browser, and so on. Okay, so this is the application softwares, compilers, text editors, web browsers, users, okay, operating system and your hardware. Okay, so users are interacting with hardware devices. Okay, users are interacting with hardware devices through the operating system. So in this case, this operating system is providing interface between the computer users and computer hardware. Hardware is nothing but CPU, memory, and I/O device. I/O device. Okay? In this case, users are interacting with your hardware devices through the operating system. So in this case, this operating system is providing interface between the computer user and computer hardware. Okay, computer users and computer hardware. Okay, so next, operating system services. Operating system services. Basically, operating system is used for providing the ease of access. Second one is the resource utilization. First one, ease of use. Second one, resource utilization. Okay, some unknown users are accessing the computer systems. Some unknown users are accessing the computer systems. So in this case, this operating system is providing ease of access, ease of use services. Ease of use services. Okay, next, operating system, next main goal is resource utilization. Resource utilization. Resource utilization. Your computer system is a consist one CPU, some memory, next one some input output device. Okay, so in this case, your computer system is accessing different types of users. Different types of users parallel. Okay, so in this case, the memory or CPU or input output devices are accessed by different types of users parallelly. So in this case, operating system is providing resource utilization. Okay, efficient manner accessed by the resources. Okay, CPU nothing but processor. Next one, memory. Okay, next one, input output device. So this type of resources are utilized by the users simultaneously. So in this case, operating system is providing resource utilization efficient concept. Okay, next one, ease of use. Some unknown users are accessing your computer systems. So in this case, how to access? Okay, the instructions are given by the operating system. Okay, so this is the main goal of the operating system.